Okay guys, so welcome back to another video. Today's video is probably going to be less structured than usual and it's going to be a bit of a ramble. But the point I want to get across is why there is still a great opportunity with social media marketing and why you can still start a social media marketing agency and make, you know, decent money for yourself while still having a lot of potential to deliver value to the businesses that are actually going to pay you. So this is coming from someone who has been involved with a few different types of business models before. I've done dropshipping, I've done private label e-commerce, I've tried to be an influencer, I have freelance and done freelancing for quite a while, and now I run a social media marketing agency, so I'm a social media marketer. Okay, so from my experience in having, you know, a feel of all those different business models, all of them do work, let me just say that, all of them do work and can make you a lot of money if you're good at them. But for me, social media marketing and running an agency is the easiest. When I compare it to all of the other ones, it's just on a different level. So I get this question almost every day, and it's, Adam, is social media marketing saturated? Or are there too many social media marketing agencies? And because there's so many of them, how can I stand out? How can I actually get clients? And will they actually pay me? So a lot of these concerns come up with people, and rightfully so, I had the exact same concerns. So when you look back in 2016 or 2015, when social media marketing came to the forefront and people first were getting aware of this concept, of course, people were running marketing campaigns way before, but at that stage, this was when the whole idea of running an agency could be very profitable. So back then, it was definitely easier to get clients. So back then, you could literally pitch brands in your local area saying, look, for 1,000 euro every single month, I'm going to manage your Instagram, your Facebook, and I'm going to send out 3 or 4 emails for you every single month. Okay, you could do that, you could offer that, and you could sign a lot of clients very easily. And it's very easy to deliver a good service, because this was when people were doing nothing. They didn't even have an Instagram account. Most restaurants or local businesses probably had a Facebook page and that was it, but it was very inactive, wasn't posting frequently. So you could come in, get a few nice photos taken for them, find a freelancer or a contractor to take some photos, edit some videos, and boom, you're flying. Super easy. In the current landscape of social media marketing and running a social media marketing agency in 2020, things have changed. So there's obviously a lot more people offering these services and a lot more businesses now understand why social media marketing is so important. You can look at that and you can take that in two ways. Okay, so you can look at that and say, hey, it's saturated. There's too many marketing agencies out there. How am I going to stand out? Oh, there's no hope. On the other hand, you can look at that and say, well, now it's actually a better opportunity. Why? Because all of these businesses actually are aware of social media marketing, so I don't even have to convince them of the benefits of it. Whereas they know what it is, they know why it's useful, and I can just come in and give them a good service and they'll probably pay me for that. So like with any business and success in life, it really comes down to how you look at things. So you can look at the current landscape and say it's too saturated. But you can also look at it and say, look, actually it's easier now because businesses already know what social media marketing is, so I actually have to do less to sell them and get them to sign up with me. Now, with that being said, my biggest recommendation to anybody who wants to start a social media marketing agency is this. Pick one service and one type of client that you want to serve and just go all in with that. Back in 2016, you could just go around to any business in your local area, gyms, restaurants, pubs, whatever, and you could pitch them and probably get them results. Now you need to be specialized in one area. Pick a service, Facebook ads, Google ads, SEO, web development, content creation, social media management, email marketing, copywriting, the list goes on. Pick one of those and now pick a specific type of business that you want to help. And again, pick something that you have an interest in. For me, I like fitness. I like nutrition. I like food companies. So for me, that makes complete sense that I would serve those businesses. Now for anybody starting off, I've made a ton of other videos about how you can start off the easiest way possible, how you can sign your first client, and how you can just do all of that. So if you want to check out those videos, go onto my channel and you'll see I've got a full free playlist on how you can start social media marketing. But back to what I was rambling about before, talking about how now is actually a really good opportunity. So to recap on what we've kind of talked about so far, yes, back in 2016 or 2015, it was probably easier because you could just pitch anyone. You could offer any service, find any business, pitch them, and it was much easier to sign them up. But on the other hand, now, when you have a specific service you offer and you have a specific type of business you help, it's still just as easy. And because I've recently started helping people start a social media marketing agency, or at least start along this journey of social media marketing and offering services to businesses, I've got a lot of people come to me and say, why? Like, if it works for you, why are you helping other people do it? You know, would you not try and keep it a secret? Would you not try and hide what you're doing so that you can keep doing it, keep making money from it, and nobody comes in and competes with you? And let me just say, that's a very valid concern, and that's something I've thought about before, and I've been like, do I want to be doing this? Should I be putting this information out there? But the way I look at it is this. Because in the current landscape, like I've just explained, you need to do one thing, one service, really, really well, and you have to serve a specific type of business. So because you're offering something so specific to a certain type of people, there's still a huge amount of area in which we can all compete. And I'm confident that what we offer is something that like nobody else offers. And we've done a ton of research on this to see if there's other people doing what we do. And ultimately, there isn't. What we do, the specific service we offer, and to the specific people that we offer it to, we're unique. We've got a little moat around our business, because when you specialize like that, you have the opportunity to create your own little bubble. Your own little bubble where people can't really come in because you've got yourself established in there. So because my agency is specialized in what we do, and we have a specific type of people we serve, it's not a problem. I can still help people start their own agency, and I can still teach people the processes and how to find clients and how to do sales and all of that, because we've got ourselves in our nice little corner here. So I plan on making more videos like this where we just pick a topic and I kind of just ramble about it for a few minutes, because one, I like doing it, but two, I know that there's a lot of concerns that I would have had before I started my agency. I know if someone had answered those questions that I had before I started my agency with confidence and with clarity, I would have been so much more confident then, and I would have been able to start my agency earlier and see success earlier on. So if you have any questions related to social media marketing and running an agency, let me know in the comments, because I want to address those concerns that you might have, whether it's a limiting belief, not thinking that you're able to sign a client, or you're actually looking at the logistics of it and you don't know how much to charge or something like that. Let me know below and I will do my best to make a video about it and answer it for you. So this is a very short video compared to what we usually do and a little bit less structured, but I was on a tight schedule today. I will be completely honest, I've got a call in about 10 minutes, so I'm gonna wrap this up nice and swiftly, get onto my call, hopefully close a new client, and yeah, enjoy my day. Thank you so much for watching this far. If you're still here, which you obviously are because you're still watching the video, pound that like button for me, hit the subscribe button, and again, let me know if you have any concerns or limiting beliefs about social media marketing and running an agency, and I would love to answer that for you.